subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonsong. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 21st of September. Indian PM to visit US from September 22-26, Quad UNGA talks with President Biden on agenda. MQM founder Altaf Hussain vows to free Sindh province from Pakistan. And Taliban say no Al-Qaeda or Islamic State in Afghanistan days after Jalalabad attacks. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi will leave for the United States on Wednesday, his first major foreign visit during the COVID-19 pandemic. PM Modi will meet US President Joe Biden at the White House, and the two leaders will have a bilateral meet to bolster security, defense and trade. He will participate in the first ever in-person Quad Leaders Summit and also address the United Nations General Assembly in New York this week.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi will be leaving for the United States on Wednesday to have a one-to-one meeting with President Joe Biden and participate in the first ever in-person Quad Leaders Summit and also address the United Nations General Assembly in New York, Foreign Secretary Harshvardhan Shringala said on Tuesday. Addressing a press briefing in capital New Delhi, Shringala said PM Modi and President Biden are expected to discuss ways to stem radicalization and combat terrorism. The two leaders are also expected to discuss ways to bolster defense and trade ties, among others, between the two countries.
The bilateral meetings would also feature current regional security situation following recent developments in Afghanistan, our stakes as a neighbor and a long-standing and preferred development partner of the people of Afghanistan. In this context, we would undoubtedly discuss the need to stem radicalism, extremism, cross-border terrorism, and the dismantling of global terrorist networks.
PM Modi will later address the general debate of the 76th session of the UN General Assembly UNGA on September 25 in New York. As per India's permanent representative to United Nations, T.S. Tirumurthy, the issues related to terrorism will be extremely important at UNGA, and India has played an active role in shaping global counter-terrorism strategy. This will be Modi's first visit to the United States since President Joe Biden assumed charge early this year.
Authorities in Moradabad district of India's northern Uttar Pradesh state on Tuesday released mosquito fish into local water bodies to curb the alarming rise in dengue and malaria infections. Several hundred cases of mosquito-related infections have been reported over the past 1 month in parts of northern India, more intensely in Uttar Pradesh. Local administration in Moradabad district of India's northern Uttar Pradesh state released mosquito fish or gambusia into local water bodies on Tuesday to curb the alarming rise in dengue and malaria infections. The fish performs its namesake function and its mosquito larva in water and has been over the years used for biological control of mosquito population. Several hundred cases of mosquito-related infections such as malaria and dengue are spreading their wings across northern India, more intensely in the most populous state of Uttar Pradesh.
Iski khasiyat hoti hai ki jo hai ye malaria ke jo hai rog se hota hai jo machharon se hota hai to machharon ko khati hai aur machharon ki jo larva paida hote hain wo pani pe rehte hain wo usko khati hai. Hai na? Aur je hum logon ne kya naam is filhal to jo wahan se Lakhimpur Khiri se mangai gayi thi. और लखीमपुर खीरी से मंगाने के बाद उसको जो है विभिन्न नगर निगम के जो तीन तालाबों में डाली गई है.
Meanwhile, hospitals across Uttar Pradesh have continued to witness long queues of patients of viral fever and dengue since the past 1 month. A health official in Kanpur city said they are conducting all tests including COVID-19, dengue and malaria on patients who are reporting fever.
अब तो नियम ये है कि कोविड और मलेरिया और डेंगू की जांच हर फीवर में कराई जाएगी और लैब से आप पता चलेंगे तो कम से कम 40-50 मरीजों की जांच तो होती ही पर डे। अब जो डेंगू नहीं है मलेरिया नहीं निकलता उसको वायरल में माना जाता है ना तो नॉर्मल में माना जाता है।
Dengue fever, which can cause intense pain in muscles and joints, is spread by the bite of Aedes aegypti mosquito. The insect thrives in the mega cities of the tropics. Most patients survive dengue, but it is estimated to kill about 20,000 every year globally. Moving on, founder leader of Mudahida Qaumi movement Altaf Hussain has said it is his mission to free Sindh province from occupation of Pakistan at any cost. The exile leader blamed, though there is a civilian government in Pakistan, the fact is the whole country is under the control of the army.
Altaf Hussain, the founder and leader of MQM, the Mutahida Qaumi movement, has said it is his mission to free Sindh province from Pakistan at any cost. In a video message from London, the self-exiled leader blamed, though there is a civilian government in Pakistan, the fact is that the whole country is under control of the army. He also called on Sindhis to unite for the freedom of Sindh from military occupation.
हम सिंधु देश की आजादी के लिए बड़ी से बड़ी कुर्बानी देने के लिए तैयार हैं। सिंध हमारी धरती है। सिंधियों, खुदा के वास्ते आप समझो हम सिंध को आजाद कराएंगे।
Altaf Hussain's MQM, a mainstream political party of Muhajirs, has dominated Sindh's capital city of Karachi since the 1980s. When security forces cracked down on the party in the 1990s, Altaf Hussain sought asylum in the United Kingdom. Even from exile in London, Altaf Hussain has been a vocal critic of Pakistan's policies and often blames it of using force to muzzle dissenting voices in the country.
More news from Pakistan. Locals in Pakistan's Lahore city have expressed dismay over frequent hike in prices of food and other essential commodities, which has affected domestic budgets and made their life difficult. They said the rising inflation has even made edibles unaffordable.
Locals in Pakistan's Lahore city have expressed anguish over the frequent price hike of essential commodities in recent months in the country. Locals said that they are unable to afford even the basic daily kitchen needs as the Prime Minister Imran-led government has increased the price of food items, including sugar, clarified butter and flour, which have affected their domestic budget. They complained the price of chicken has increased to Rs. 350 while clarified butter has risen to Rs. 320. And the government has done nothing to address the problem of rising food prices.
Hukumat aayi hai, humne to socha hai ki chalo tabdili aa jayegi, koi mulk ka halaat set ho jayenge. Abhi aap ghee dekh le, 320 rupaye kilo de rahe hain. Aate ka thela de rahe hain 1050 rupaye ka 1100 ka. Bhai maade bande ka kaam aajkal bahut khatam ho gaya hai.
Meanwhile, opposition parties in Pakistan have also slammed the government's move to introduce a hike in fuel prices last week. The Awami National Party held massive rallies earlier this week across Khyber Pakhtunkhwa against rising inflation and unemployment in the country and demanded PM Imran Khan's resignation.
In news from Afghanistan, Taliban spokesperson Zabihullah Mujahid on Tuesday said there was no evidence of Islamic State or Al-Qaeda militants being in the country, days after Islamic State claimed responsibility for bomb attacks in the eastern city of Jalalabad. Addressing a news conference in Kabul, Mujahid repeated pledges that there would be no attacks on third countries from Afghanistan from militant movements. The Islamic State had also claimed a suicide bomb attack at Kabul airport last month that killed 13 US troops and scores of Afghan civilians attempting to flee the country following Taliban takeover. Meanwhile, the Taliban on Tuesday also announced appointments for several deputy ministers, although none were women. The first appointments to the Taliban interim government were announced earlier this month, drawn exclusively from loyalist ranks, with established hardliners in all key posts. More news from Afghanistan. Some Afghan girls returned to primary schools with segregated classes after the Taliban last week announced state and private schools at primary and secondary level would reopen more than a month of the country's takeover. But older girls face an anxious wait with no clarity over if and when they would be able to resume their studies at the secondary school level. A small group of female students from Afghanistan's Western Herat province staged a protest on Monday, calling for the Taliban to reopen schools for girls in grades 7 to 12. Failing that, the students holding placards as a symbol of protest say equivalent levels of boys' schools should remain closed until the girls' schools can also reopen. In recent days, some Afghan girls have returned to primary schools with gender-segregated classes. But older girls have faced an anxious wait, with no clarity over if and when they would be able to resume their studies at the secondary school level.
مکتبای پسرانه باز شده ولی از دخترها باز نشدن به خاطر که اینا میگن که شما اینا میگن که دخترها حق اجازه ندارن که درس بخونن در حالی که دختران امروز دختران 25 سال پیش نیستن دختران از 25 سال پیش تا امروز تحولات و پیشرفت‌های چشمگیری داشتن بنابراین ما هدف ما این هست که مکتبا شروع بشه چرا که ما هدف‌های زیادی داریم ما 10 سال زحمت کشیدیم درس خواندیم و دوست داریم که دوباره ادامه تحصیل بدیم و دوباره تحصیل بتحصیل.
Last week, the Education Ministry said boys' secondary schools would soon reopen, but made no mention of girls. Taliban spokesman Zabihullah Mujahid in an interview told Reuters on Sunday that they want to regulate women's commute to educational centers. This needs action and time. Mujahid also vowed that women would be able to work within the framework of Sharia law and that the Ministry of Women's Affairs of the former government have not been dissolved. When Taliban Islamists last ruled Afghanistan from 1996 to 2001, girls were not allowed to attend school and women were banned from work and education. Taliban officials have said they will not return to their fundamentalist policies, including the ban on girls receiving an education. Women from the fishermen community in southern India's Rameshwaram town are harnessing the potential of seaweed farming in the shallow waters of the sea and earning their livelihood. Scores of fishermen and their families are opting it as an alternative career to fishing.
Women, mainly from the fishing community in Rameswaram, a Hindu holy town in India's southern Tamil Nadu state, are harnessing the potential of seaweed farming. Introduced by the Central Marine Fisheries Research Station, seaweed farming is helping fishermen and their families to earn their livelihood as an alternative career to fishing. These soft algae, also known as kappa algae or carrageenan, are grown for around 40 days using floating bamboo raft method. They are used in the manufacturing of soft drinks and food processing acids. Seaweed, several species of marine algae, has a good demand worldwide in food sector due to its high nutrient value, pharmaceutical and textile industries. However, emerging evidence shows that seaweed can sometimes cause harm and spread diseases and pests, a UN report said.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. Indian PM to visit US from September 22-26, Quad UNGA talks with President Biden on agenda. MQM founder Altaf Hussain vows to free Sindh province from Pakistan. And Taliban say no Al-Qaeda or Islamic State in Afghanistan days after Jalalabad attacks. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Tech TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.